Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, you will see how to customize the Angular AutoComplete component using built-in templates. The AutoComplete component supports several options to customize list item, group title, header, and footer elements. Looking at this example, you can see the Angular AutoComplete pop-up showing employee names and images. Each list item is split into two columns, one for the name and the other for the image. You can see the pop-up has a customized header and footer in the autocomplete. Now, I will show you the code snippet to achieve this customization using my existing Angular autocomplete application. Let me open my existing Angular application, where I have added the Angular autocomplete component with basic properties. I bound employee names as the data and mapped the appropriate data source field to the fields property. I set the placeholder property value to select a name. Follow the link provided in the card and description to learn the basics of adding an Angular autocomplete component to an app. Now, I run this example using the command ng-serve. So, you can see the autocomplete component showing employee names. Now, I will show you how to add images for list items. Within the autocomplete code, first, I create a template using the ng-template tag and assign a template reference variable, item-template. I want to display employee names and their images in autocomplete items, so, first, I modify the existing autocomplete data source by adding one more field, image with appropriate values. To add the employee images, I define division and image elements inside the item-template section. Then, I add a source path for the image using a source attribute. I set an alternate name for the image. Next, I assign the name field to another division element for adding employee names. I have defined a temporary variable named data to access the data source field inside this template section. I also define a few CSS styles for this item template. So here, you can see the autocomplete component, showing employee names and images. Now, let me show you how to add a header to the autocomplete pop-up. Within the autocomplete code, first, I create a template using the ng-template tag and assign the template reference variable, header-template. To display photo and employee name as headers in the pop-up list, I define the span elements with the text, photo, and employee name. I also define a few CSS styles for this header template. And now, you can see the autocomplete pop-up displays the text, photo, and employee name as headers. If I like to show the total number of list items at the bottom of the pop-up, then I can use the footer template. Within the autocomplete code, first, I create a template using the ng-template tag and assign the template reference variable, footer template. Then, I define the span element with the text, total list items, 8. I also define a few CSS styles for this footer template. So now, look at the autocomplete component. The pop-up is displayed with the text, total list items, 8 at the bottom. Next, I will show you how to group these items using the group template property. First, I define one more field, called country, with appropriate values on each object of the existing autocomplete data source. Then, I map this newly defined data source field, country, to the group by option within the fields property. I want to display the country names in bold and italic font, so I create a template using the ng-template tag and assign the template reference variable, group template. To access the country name, I add the country field inside the bold and italic elements, using this temporary variable. Now, when you look at the autocomplete component, the data items are grouped under the categories England and USA with bold and italic font. Finally, let me show you how to customize the autocomplete component with a no-records template. I define a template using the ng-template tag and assign the template reference variable, no-records-template. Then, I add a span element with the value no-data-available and remove the data source, fields, and placeholder properties from the autocomplete code. Next, I remove other templates from the autocomplete code. Now, when you look at the autocomplete, the pop-up list content displays the notification, no data available. In this video, we have seen how to customize the Angular AutoComplete components items and group titles. We have seen how to add a header and footer to the AutoComplete pop-up. Finally, we saw how to customize the AutoComplete component with a no-records template. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite, with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.